Get in there. Got you. Can you use this? Okay. I got a use for you. More scrap. More bounties. Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
Gotta take a closer look. All right, where?
Maybe in one of these. Give this to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait. All this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
Ah!
Whoa, hold on, hold on. They're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Okay, stay low, stay low.
Hope we got enough fuel to get back. Going all over hill and back today.
Got plenty of fuel. I double checked.
You getting hungry?
Time now.
Field note 000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Oh,
shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Can't you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're sleeping like this, sir. No.
And I asked if you were going with Kevin. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Seal the caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey.
The Nero guy, the soldier. Book Sarah. He had an ID badge. What was the name?
God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't...
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out. Finally.
Deke, you there? Did you say you were heading north?
Boozman, no. You know, I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Yeah. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Deke, it means a lot to me.
Take care of her. Just get some rest. Deacon out. Thank you, brother. I'll be by.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Who remembers the skid rows of this great country? People living on the streets in boxes and tents because they couldn't afford the American dream. Some of those good people fought for this very country, only to have the feds forget about them as soon as they were done with them. PTSD doesn't stand for post-traumatic stress disorder. It stands for put them soldiers down. Well, we're all homeless now, living in the wilderness in the way of our forebears. The feds used to think we needed their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. What we need now is a strong will, determination, and trust in each other. The feds were never gonna give us that. And you? You want our trust? You gotta earn it. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's great. That's great. Radio Free Oregon is on the air once again. Oh, Jesus, what have I done? Yeah.
another MMU. Wonder what Nero left behind this time. Off figures.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.
Let's go.
Here we go. Needed this. That's it. Yeah, now we're in business.
Yes, finally. All right.
Yeah, a Nero injector. Let's see if it still works. Another micro recorder.
Hey,
these are being exploring what the hell you guys are doing.
We are under attack!
Deschutes County Militia. That man out there, Colonel Garrett, he's all the authorization I need.
Militia?
What
are they doing?
Just following orders. You do the same, maybe we let you come with us.
Clear!
They're sending explosives!
We're closing the highway. Someone's gotta stop this goddamn plague.
Can't do
this. Move.
Stop!
Shit! Get down! Get down!
Deschutes County Militia? What the hell? I wonder what happened to them.
Sniper ambush, oh goddammit. Fuck you like that, huh? Shoot me, you fucking bastard.
Jesus, Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit!
You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Well, except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy.
Marauder camp. These are the assholes who've been ambushing the roads around here.
Ah!
This is it. Yeah, oh, this camp is gonna be crawling.
Nah, you gotta leave the bike out here, Deke, or it'll pull all of them down on you.
Some bitch is hiding in these...
Okay. Well, there's gotta be a nest in this shack. Oh yeah, a nest. Okay, you boys just keep right on sleeping. Don't pay no attention to me. Here? Yep.
Sons of bitches, come on! Thank you.
looks like the kind of place you want to call home, yeah? God damn it, what'd you all shit yourself at once? Jesus Christ. Goddamn freaks. What the hell are you doing in here? Huh? This place is a death trap. Getting kinda cold out here. Thought I'd help you out. The last of them. Bruce, it's done. I cleared those nests. Yeah, but I wanted to clear him while it was still light. Yeah, but I wanted to clear him while it was still light out. You know how the sunlight bothers him.
Yeah, that's probably the way to do it. Anyway, thanks for doing that, Dick.
Get some shut-eye, Boozer. Deacon out.
Cope. This man I tracked down, we kill.
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Now look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them is a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
This is it.
There he is! Silver helmet. Red gas tank. That's it.
Oh, shit! The hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, just ride out, and then just send some shopping. Shot Manny, you know, who fixed my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You are Copeland's toadies, you little bitch! That's what you are, you little bitch!
Cope, it's done. Got him.
You
mark down these coordinates and send your man out here. Yeah, he's alive. Well, I won't promise you how long he's gonna stay that way. Deacon out. Boozer, you there? I was just calling a checkup on you.
Yeah, Deacon, come here.
Hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we're riding north, just like you said.
I hope so. God, I miss you on the road.
You just work on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out.
At the the Humane Society.
Good to see you,
Dee. Had a small office and a dog pen outside of Sisters. Had maybe 100.
Can I help you?
Strays mostly. A few had owners.
Good choice. That'll last you. Now that's what I'm talking about. You definitely need that. Freaks ain't gonna mess with you now. Is that all you need? Come by anytime. You come here if you need anything.
It's worse than that. Her fur started falling out and she just turned. We had to